does this needs heroes. Here's some of the great writers I grew up on. Starry night. Paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on summer's day with eyes that know the darkness of my soul. Shadows on the hill. Sketch the trees and the daffodil. Catch the breeze and the winter chills of colors in the snowy land. Now I understand what you try to say to me and how you suffered for your sanity. How you tried to set them free, they would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will. Guys like Jim Croce, guys like Sweet Baby James Taylor, right? Oh, such beautiful stuff. And then something happens in your life, and you write a song about it. But then, other people start to pick up that that's their life as well, just a different story. And all of a sudden, it hits you. Being normal is pretty cool. It's being one of the people. I love this song for what it means to me. I love it for what it means for everyone else as well. Just the other night at a hometown football game, my wife and I ran into my old high school flames. And as I introduced them, the past came back to me, and I couldn't help but think big things used to. She was the one that I'd wanted for all time. Each night I'd spend praying that God would make her mine. And if he'd only grant me this wish I wish back then, I'd never ask for anything again. Sometimes I thank God for unanswered prayers. Remember when talking to the man upstairs, and just because he may not answer, it doesn't mean he don't care. Some of God's greatest gifts Has anybody in here
seen the big man in concert? Anybody?
Okay. So I know you don't recognize me because usually I have this headset strapped on my head. This thing's a little hard to tape on your head.
So we're going to manually do it tonight.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Because I'm the boss of my ship. I remember I was raised right in the middle of America, in Yukon, Oklahoma. Okay, my dad was a Korean War veteran, United States Marine Corps. So my mom was all of 5 foot and she was tougher than he was, trust me. Last of six kids. So we grew up on Buck Owens, George Jones, Charlie Bride, Merle Haggard. One of the greatest writers this country will ever know, great Merle Haggard. Unbelievable songwriter, people. And this guy wrote about real stuff. Well, the warden led a prisoner down the hallway to his death. So I stood up to say goodbye. Influence that Haggard have on music itself, all genres. The maybe greatest quoted songwriter in our culture. Bob Dylan listened to country music all the time. Some of the greatest heroes out there. Was approached to do a song with Bob's in a movie called Hope Flows to End of the Lines. It's a beautiful song. Loved it. We were lucky enough to have a number one with it, and it did really well for us, and I felt really good about myself until my youngest daughter, which would come a decade later, turned about 14, came in and said, "Oh my God, Dad, Adele has a song you've got to hear." It just shows that no matter how you dress up a great song is forever. When the rain's blowing in your face, and the whole world is on pace, I would offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. Even shadows and stars. There is no one to drive to. I would hold you for a million years. Thank you, you're mine. Storms are raging on a rolling sea. Down the highway. winds of change are blowing wild. Free on, you ain't seen nothing like me. So now, your blank canvas has pain. Your blank canvas has storytelling. Your blank canvas has conversation of the common man. Now it's time to put a little in it. You know what I mean? Oh, good stuff, man. I don't even know how to describe this, but the second you feel it, you'll go, oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about, right? So, I'm sitting in the morning sun. Now I'll be sitting when evening comes, watching the ships roll in, and I'll watch them go away from here. Oh, I'll be sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away, sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Evil. Whatever that is, right? You just can't get enough of it. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. There ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, I wonder what time when she's gone. Wonder if she's gonna stay. There ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. I love that stuff. It's fun. Now, right? Now you got your paint. You got your storytelling. The voice of the common man and the huge. Now it's time for some of us. This is the last ingredient. Now it gets really nasty. So right now you're imagining how screwed up I really must be. Well, then my brothers bring in this album into the house. It was Cat Stevens' Tea for the Tillamook. I'm just a very young, impressionable kid at this point, but you hear. Now that I've lost everything to you, you see you wanna start something new. When you're breaking my heart, you leave them. Baby, I'm leaving. But if you gotta leave, take good care. Hope you meet a lot of nice friends out there. But then remember, there's a lot of bad out there. Anyhow, well, maybe it's a wild world. It's hard to get by.
Teenage kid yourself, and you're starting to look for that music that belongs to you, not your brothers, not your mom, not your dad. You can imagine how cool it was to be a teenager when this cat shows up. So, wrap all that up in one person, right? And now, in 1980, I fall in love with a guy named George Strait. This is my guy, and I want to be George. So I moved to Nashville to be George, and then you start writing. And what's fun about getting to play people is for the last 10 minutes, I've just been horsing around. Now, the band's about to kick in. People. You ever seen those commercials like before, after, after? You're about to see after, right here, man. I love these cats. These guys, we've been playing. There's five of us up here. I'm gonna start kind of spinning out. There's five of the regular group that we tour with up here that we've been together since 1988. And we kind of did our own thing. Two more guys up here that's played on every record since the beginning here as well. Very sweet guys, studio guys. So I'm here among family back here in the back and just having a great time. You're thinking about playing country music. You want to tell a story. You want to paint a picture. You want to get the bounce, go back, and you want to put muscle in it. Might come out something like this. I went to work, heard that song. A teenage kid so far from home. Was this love that went over? Held down to make it on her own. You were 1,000 miles from nowhere. It feels as far as I can see. We'll need something from each other. I knew it, yeah, that might be. Till she came to me one evening. Hot cup of coffee and a smile. In a dress that I was certain. She hadn't worn it quite a while. There was a difference in her laughter. There was a softness in her eyes. Recognize she got a need to feel the thunder. Starting to get cocky. How many people are songwriters? Let me see them. Amen. How many people are dreamers? Amen. If you're a dreamer, you're a songwriter. I'm going to give you a little hint in songwriting here. Think of it as songwriting 101. You have your major chords. That's Cowboy D right there, people. Play that all day long. Nothing's bad in Cowboy D. You change one little chord. Now all of a sudden, nothing's good in Cowboy D. One of the greatest road anthems ever written, people, came out of this chord. Because it's endless. It's the highway. On a long, lonesome highway, east of Omaha, you can listen to the engine moaning out its one note song. You think about the woman or the girl you never known before. That's sad. Remember the difference. Cowboy D. Happy. Cowboy D minor. For Seeger, that note was the road. For me, this feels more like thunderclouds rolling out of the road. Down summer night, rain drops on the windshield. There's a storm moving in. He's heading back from somewhere that he never should have been. Thunder rolls. Thank you.
Coronavirus. Kidding.
She rushes out towards him, thankful he's alive. Long wind and rain, a strange new perfume blows, and the lightning flashes in her eyes, but he knows that she knows.
Now, if I were at his concert, I'd be woo-hoo and carrying on like a Looney Tune, because that's the way I am at a concert.
Your way in, fight your way out every night. You get up there and all you did was sing other people's songs, but you had sing-alongs, and I mean sing-alongs for the ages. It's 9 o'clock Saturday, the regular crowd shows in. There's no man sitting next to me to his tonic.
He says, son, can you play me a melody? I'm not really sure how it goes, but it's sad and it's sweet, and I knew it completely. When I wore a younger man's glow, he said, sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight, yeah. For we're all in the mood for a melody, and you got us feeling alright, and we'll just sing that. La, 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 and sing along, like, long, long time ago, and I can still remember when we used to make peace, and I knew if I had my